What's going on, guys? Your host, Buffalo Bob. And just a quick disclaimer, if you hear any background noise in the background of this video, that's not me. It's a helicopter flying around my place. So we have a helicopter flying around my house, and we have the Blue Angels practicing before the 4th of July at Jones Beach in Long Island. So I wanted to throw that out there real quick. So with that being said, let's begin the video. So the Sabres have been fairly active yesterday on the first day of free agency. And to my surprise, and I think a lot of people were thrown off by it, it was completely frustrating to keep track of everything on Twitter with free agency, because Twitter had an issue going on with the company, and there was some issue, technical issue, whatever, and we were only able to be limited to 600 views per day, which is like 5 swaps a day or whatever, but I think that's kind of slowly going away at this point. I mean, I looked at it this morning, it looked okay, but I haven't really seen anything since then, and I'm sure they fixed it, but who the hell knows at this point. But, so yesterday, as I was able to progress, I was working as well. It was one of the busiest times of the year for me. On a Saturday, you know, with, you know, doing normal stuff at work. So as I was coming home from lunch, because free agency started on my lunch break, I was coming home, I was driving, and I got a notification on my watch, because I looked in my stoplight or whatever, you know, on my way to my job, and the next thing you know, I read a notification that said the Buffalo Sabres signed Erik Johnson, yeah, the Erik Johnson from the Colorado Avalanche, for a one-year deal for $3.5 million. So, yeah, sorry, $3.25 million, my apologies. So, Erik Johnson, my first initial reaction to this move was, wow, of all the teams that Erik Johnson had the opportunity to end his career in, he would have chose Boston. He would have chose Vegas. He would have chose Carolina. He could have chose a Stanley Cup contender. But instead, he chose the Buffalo Sabres. And he said specifically that Buffalo, to him, reminds him of when Colorado was coming up in the five-year span, that they were becoming a really good team. And then, of course, in 2022, they won the Stanley Cup. And Erik Johnson was on that team when they won the Cup. And so Colorado had a little bit of a cab crutch to do. So they let an old fan favorite go in Erik Johnson. And let's be honest with ourselves, I love this move because, for one, the Sabres don't really have a veteran voice in the back end on their blue line. I mean, yeah, you have Samuelsson, you have Power, you have Dahlin, of course. But that's really it outside of that. I mean, you have Riley Stillman and Henry Jokiharju, and then so far. So bringing in Erik Johnson, to me, is a good veteran presence. And apparently, he's really good friends with Kyle Laposo, so that was a big reason why he felt like he had the urge to come to Buffalo. And he kind of just took it and ran with it. And it's a one-year deal, so if it doesn't pan out, they can always trade him at the deadline. But I don't think that's going to be the case. I think if he succeeds, I think that he's going to stay in Buffalo for at least maybe another year or two. Because keep in mind, Erik Johnson is 35 years old. So he's not going to be playing, you know, top 4 minutes anymore. He's not what he used to be. And considering he was on Colorado for 15 years, it's a long time. So for him to go from Colorado, who won the Stanley Cup a year ago, to the Buffalo Sabres, who's an up-and-coming young team, they're getting better by the day. And I think when you bring in a guy like Erik Johnson, you know you're doing something right. So I love that move. You know, it's a good veteran move. I like it. And I have nothing really to complain about, to be honest with you. So that's that. So Erik Johnson, great move. The other move that the Sabres made, which completely threw me off guard, by the way, because I did not expect that to happen, was the Sabres signed Connor Clifton, the former offensive defenseman for the Boston Bruins, to a 3-year deal worth about $3.33 million. When I saw that, I was completely thrown off. You know, I didn't expect him to come to Buffalo. I figured, you know, he was going to sign with the Bruins and he was going to, you know, stay in Boston and long term and all that jazz. Connor Clifton is at that age of his prime where he's 28 years old. His contract doesn't end until he's like, what, 31? So if he's that good, and I think he will be because he's been in the NHL now for 5 seasons, all with the Boston Bruins, I think, to me, that really shows that Kevin Adams is really trying to improve the blue line. I mean, obviously, if you're a Sabres fan, there's a famous video of Connor Clifton back in December against the Sabres at TD Garden when he fought Peyton Krebs. That was when the Bruins were undefeated at home at the time, and the Sabres won in OT. And in that fight, Peyton Krebs lost to Connor Clifton. And it's just funny now how that the two of them are now going to be teammates. So it's kind of like saying, hey, sorry, I was on the Bruins. Now I'm a Saber. So I think it's unique to see a Stanley Cup champion and a division rival opponent coming to the team. So I think that works out really well for Buffalo's blue line. So I think unless they have a trade in place with another team, I don't think the Sabres are going after, you know, Noah Hanifin or Brett Pesce for that matter. Because I think, for one, they want to keep the core as young as possible. The Clifton deal could be a bit risky if he doesn't pan out, but I think he will. I think watching him on the Boston Bruins for 5 years, I think, does enough. And, you know, like I said, he's an offensive defenseman. He gets into fights. He throws his body. I love it. So it brings grit. That's what I love about it. Eric Johnson is the same way. So I definitely think that the Sabres addressed their biggest needs, which was on the defense. They needed help with the blue line. Now, I think they're going to shift their gears on trying to get a goalie, because Tristan Jarry just re-signed with the Penguins. I mean, I'm laughing hysterically because I did not want Tristan Jarry. That guy sucks, and he's always injury-prone. Connor Hellebuck is really the only one left. I mean, Jonas Korpisalo went to Ottawa yesterday, so he's out of the picture. So you can say, well, what about Hellebuck? Well, what about Devin Levi? The Sabres can't just have Devin Levi and UPL. UPL is horrendous. He's injury prone. He's inconsistent. You can't have that. You need a veteran who can stay healthy, who can teach Devin Levi how to be the guy. You know what I mean? Like, you can't just sit back and just have those two guys, you know, lead the team and then they become mediocre. And I'm not saying it can't happen, because it happened with the Tampa Bay Lightning with Andre Vasilevsky. You know, when Vasilevsky got drafted in the first round back in 2012 by the Tampa Bay Lightning, he was the backup for at least 5 years. And then Ben Bishop was there. He got shipped to LA. Vasilevsky then took over, and then he became one of the best goalies in the league. So I think that's the plan for Devin Levi, is to get him a veteran presence who can teach him the ropes of how to be a professional in the NHL. I definitely think it'd be serviceable, but then again, either by free agency or by trade, because Dustin Tokarski is not going to be the guy. He's an AHL depth guy, so he can go to the AHL. Same with Kevin Cooley. He can go to the AHL as well. Subban went to the Blues, so those two can go. No, but I think it's really just bolstering the main team. Like, Rochester, I'm not really that worried about. Rochester's fine. But it's more of just trying to build the team. It's more of just trying to, you know, build the bolster of that blue line. You know, adding Eric Johnson, adding Connor Clifton. Those two guys are going to be huge contributors to the team moving forward. And I can't wait to see that. Although, I will say, I do expect more moves to be made by the Sabres, by Kevin Adams. I expect them to trade Olofsson. I expect them to be one of the two finalists for Connor Hellebuck. I wouldn't be surprised if it was them or the New Jersey Devils. No, there's a lot to see this year. So, Tyson Jost is back, which is huge. So, there's a lot. Of course, Zemgus Girgensons, Kyle Laposo, whatever. And a lot of people, 24 hours before free agency, were very upset that they didn't bring back Tyson Jost. And they're like, ah, what's Kevin Adams doing? I'm going to be so mad if they're going to protect Laposo and Girgensons over Jost, and Jost is only 25. Yeah, I get that. But at this point where Tyson Jost is in his career, a former first-round pick who is not projected to be a goal scorer is a fourth-line center. He's a good depth guy to have. I love Tyson Jost. But that's just the reality of the situation. Because then again, you're talking about a mixture of veterans who are on the Sabres, and they got to get a little younger in a couple of years. You know, Eric Johnson, one-year deal. Oposo, one-year deal. Girgensons, one-year deal. So really, it's more of just trying to put the pieces together. And I think Kevin Adams knows exactly what he's doing. I mean, they got Matt Savoy in the system. They just drafted Zach Benson. They're both in the WHL right now. They're both developing. Yuri Kulig's in the AHL. So there's a lot of moving parts of what's happening. And then next year, I didn't really look at the 2024 free agency frenzy, because this draft class this year specifically is very weak. But I wouldn't be shocked if the Sabres went and got more depth scoring. I wouldn't be surprised if they went and got a top six forward, you know, in a trade with, like, say, like, with Victor Olofsson. I wouldn't be surprised if they got another defenseman or if they got a goaltender. I really don't know. But I think Kevin Adams is very aware of what he has to do. And I like what the team's doing going forward. And if he makes the right moves and pushes the right buttons, the Sabres are going to be a playoff team this year. So, well, I really like what the Sabres did on the first day of free agency. You know, bringing a Johnson, bringing a Clifton. I love it. So, with that being said, let me guys know what you think in the comment section below. And I'll talk to you guys later. And go Sabres.